Hi, my name is Alaric Hammacher. I would like to show you how to edit 3D using IDEO 6.5. Open the software and you're welcome with the start dialog. Here you can choose a new project and you just enter the name of your new project. When you're done, hit OK. And the main user interface will appear. So there are different parts. I will quickly explain this to you. So you have your sequence editor, you have a bin for clips and effects, and you have a player and recorder. And finally an information window, which you will need later to see different information about settings that you have made. Now you see several informations are in different tabs and you can select the headers of audio or video depending later which one you want to change or which one you want to edit. Now you see we have no clips in our project so far, so we're going to create a new folder which we will call Source, and you will hit this little logo here with a folder and an arrow to import clips. So select on your hard drive or your camera a folder containing the images you would like to use. Make sure they are transferred to your project folder and click open to import them. It takes a little while to make a preview and also for the sound to make waveforms that are ready. And you can change your sequence name to your first movie. So in order, if you have several tabs or several timelines, you can keep all of this. So if you would like to change the project settings, you go to the main tab and choose project settings. So you see all the settings are here. One which is very important for us is the stereoscopic editing. Make sure this is enabled. And the render format is the one that should be the highest here for this, which is Canopus HQX Superfine. Then click OK when you're happy with these settings. The next thing I would like to show you is how to change the stereoscopic viewing mode. Since we're doing a 3D project, you have under the top menu View a stereoscopic mode where you can choose left only, right only, the difference mode in case you need to detect errors, or top and bottom, or side by side, or line interlace, depending on what your monitor is able to show. If you would like to use anaglyph glasses, just choose anaglyph or side by side, depending if your monitor can show this, and we will put it to anaglyph here so you can see what this looks like. The next thing I would like to show you is how to edit by dragging into the sequence. So you have these little markers which show out and in, and by selecting the head or the editing mode, you can choose how to position the clip on the timeline. So the first thing, you double click on the source clip, you set an in and an out point, and you drag it onto the sequence. You can choose another clip. Here again, you move the playhead, you click in, out, and you drag it behind the other. If you like to work faster, you can also use the keyboard and press in, I, and out, O. These shortcuts are very helpful if you want to work a little bit faster. Now, if you're happy with your edit, you can play the playhead, or you can also decide to add some extra effects. So stop the movie and you can go to the effects bin here, and for example, let's add a dissolve. So we will go to transitions 2D and you just choose the transition and put it on the last row of the clip, on the very bottom. And here you see we have the dissolve effects are visible, and you can also by drag and drop change the duration of these transitions. So this is the way how you add fade in and fade out to your sequence. You can go back to the bin and use those effects if you want to continue editing, and if you want to, for example, cut a scene that is a bit long, you have this special button which lets you split a clip, and then you can delete the rest. And of course you have suppressed the dissolve, which you can add again by going to the effects bin. For this you choose in the file menu the print to file from the export menu. And the first thing we want to do is to export the movie in an H.264 AVC format, which is commonly used, like MP4. And you see that we have different stereoscopic modes again for the output. So now choose the appropriate setting side by side. So you will have the two movies side by side in one movie. There are additional options. You don't need to change everything. You can also set an in and output on the timeline, then you must choose export between in and out. And when you hit the export button, it will ask you for a destination. So choose the file folder where you would like to export your master output files. Select a file name. I usually write in the name SBS when it is side by side. You can also change some other options or quality settings as they are here mentioned in the basic settings. So you can change to super fine and save. And now you need to wait some time. The export process needs to render. And depending on how much effects you have, this can take a certain amount of time. You have only here a short clip, but I have accelerated this in the video now, so we don't have to wait. And you are done. There are some other options here, the magnetism. So if your clips stick to a certain point, or if you want to select only the sound or the video, or toggle from insert or override menu, these are the points you need to turn on and off. Clicking in the time sequence, you can move the playhead from one position to the next. Now we want to change the stereoscopic adjustments, and for this we have a special video filter. You go to the effects and find the stereoscopic adjuster. The stereoscopic adjuster, you can just take it and drag it on the clip you want to change, and you see on the right bottom side in the information window the stereo adjuster effect. And when you double click on it, you have the settings that go up. So you can choose rectify. This is for automatic alignment with two cameras. You don't need this. And you have the possibility to change the far and near with the horizontal translation. And please make sure auto trimming is set so you don't have black bars that appear when you change these settings. When you're done, click OK. And you also have access to general geometric settings via the information window So this is where these information are. The next thing we're going to show is how to export two separate clips. So we want one left iMovie and one right iMovie. So we go again in File, Export, Print to File. We choose the kind of container we like with the codec. And here in the stereoscopic processing, we choose separate left and right. Now we hit the export button, and when we choose the destination now here, the file name will be transformed by Edios according to the name you choose, and the program will add underscore L and underscore right to the left and right video and will automatically create two files. So here again you can change some settings. The suffix is automatic. Choose the super fine quality and OK when you're ready to render. So here again we have accelerated the process. Additional files are created automatically by Edios and contain some metadata and waveform information. They are generated all the time automatically when the software is running. The last step I would like to show you is how to export from Edios to QuickTime. And this can be necessary if we want, for example, to continue working in another software which is not able to read the codecs produced by Edios. And this is a way to bypass the limitation. So if we have installed another codec in our system, we can choose, for example, here QuickTime, export QuickTime movie as format. And in order to export two separate files, you choose again a name. In this case, we will add the codec name to the title, DNxHD, which is the codec used by Avid and in many different post-production programs. So once you have set up this, you again have names for your two files, and you can access the QuickTime settings by hitting the settings window. So now you have here all the codecs on your system inside QuickTime, and for DNxHD you need to show exactly the format as well as the frame rate and bit depth. And when you're done, you click OK. We don't need it to prepare for internet streaming, but we would like to render the best possible sound quality, and the rest of the settings is okay. Okay, we confirm, and when we are ready, we hit okay for rendering. I hope this little tutorial was interesting for you and give you some idea what you can do with the software. There are many other possibilities, you need to play around and find them out. Also lots of documentation on the internet. I hope you will enjoy and see you on the next video.